And so it begins. See ya.
Okay.
Bye. Yes, indeed. So it begins. A little bit apprehensive, I've got to say, but ahead of me lies 220 miles of off-road journey. Well, actually 240, because I've got 10 miles to get to the beginning of the journey and 10 miles to get back home from it. I'm riding the King Alfred's Way, and the King Alfred's Way is a loop, and it starts, the official start is at Winchester, but because it's a loop, you can join it anywhere, which is convenient. And for me, the convenient spot is Ashbury, which is about 10 miles away. So I'll quickly show you the bike setup. I'm riding my 25-year-old Diamondback aluminium frame bike. I've got a bivy, so I'm using a Dutch Army Hoop bivy. I've got 3 overnight camps, possibly 4 days on the trail. I've got 3,600 metres of ascent to climb and 3,600 thereabouts of descent to go down as well. The panniers this side, all my sleeping bag, and another little mat in there. This pannier's got cooking, electronics and other little devices. Got my drone. This is the equivalent to the fuel tank, so. And there's enough food in there probably for about 3 days. I may have to stock up at some point. In here, all my spares. I've got my spare inner tube, my pump, punch repair kit, tools, and the other thing is water. A little bag there which holds this camera. And for navigation, I've invested in a Garmin GPS. This is... I think it's called the Garmin, oh crumbs, what's it called? Explore. The Garmin Edge Explore 2. So that's the setup. But anyway, I'm cycling to meet up with a friend of mine. My friend Dave's going to join me for the first day. He's going to ride as far as the Thames, which is about a 25-mile journey from the beginning of the King Alfred's Way, where I join it at Ashbury. And then he's going to double back and come home. And then I'm going to continue on my way. Breaking new ground. I'm gonna stop here and do a bit of filming. Well, I'm up now on the ridgeway, just above Ashbury. So my route lies that way, all 220 miles of it, and hopefully, all being well, in 4 or 5 days' time, I should appear over there, cycling this way. I'm at a crucial part of the ride now, just literally a couple of miles in from the beginning. I'm at Wayland Smithy Long Bar. I've been here hundreds of times, but always got to come back for one more look. Wayland Smithy. Ancient Neolithic long barrow. We've got to ask the elders for a successful journey, Dave.
Yeah. You might finish up in there on the way back, Dan.
He's always got a right comment, as Dave. Well, at this point, we're just cycling up a 3% grade, and we're right next to Effington Hill Fort, and behind the hill fort, that's where the Effington White Horse is. But a bit of a pull, almost at the top now. I've got to say, I never tire of the scenery up here. It is beautiful. Nothing wrong with that view, Dave, is there?
It's lovely, isn't it?
Absolutely stunning.
What a day.
What a lovely day. This is the Peter Wren Memorial. Ah, oh, cleanse my memory. Anyway, there's a water tap here. I don't need water, but I may as well have a good glug now and then refill. Right, we're just leaving Sparshot first behind now, and on my left is the Devil's Punch Bowl. It's a lovely piece of ground carved out during the last ice age. Apparently a lot of helicopters, military helicopters and jets occasionally use it as a training area as well. Not far along here is the Segsbury Camp. And I think Segsbury Camp, it's like an Iron Age hill fort, but I think it was used mainly as a livestock enclosure. And I believe it's also dating from the Iron Age, like a lot of the hill forts do along this part of the ridgeway. Anyway, that's the next feature coming up on our left. And here we are at Lord Wantage's Monument. Apparently this was constructed on the site of some ancient Neolithic tumuli, some ancient chieftain. There's the stop. Some ancient chieftain was buried underneath all that, and then they plonked the monument on top of that. Sacrilege. Lord Wantage's Monument. We have now arrived at Skutchhammer's Knob. And you see it's got like a path which goes that way, and a path which goes that way, and it sort of leads up to a top section, and you can look down upon it. Quite overgrown. I'm interested in bits of pot or anything. Oh, that's not a bit of pot. Yeah, you can't really see much because it's overgrown. You can't get to the top of it now. But there, you can get some idea. There's a big sort of a big dip. So I don't know if it was robbed out and all the contents chucked up, and down there may have been the burial place of some ancient Neolithic chieftain, or whether it was a meeting place of the ancients. What do you reckon, Dave?
Well, it's a little bit overgrown, Sandy.
Yeah. Sound of traffic now, and we're coming to the A34 underpass. Oh, it looks a bit muddy down here. Some more of those lovely hobnobs look dry. That's ramblings of by my friend on YouTube. He recommended me these, so there you go, look.
I might trade you a couple for an apple pie, son.
I reckon we can do a deal there.
You reckon you can do a deal, do you?
Yeah, definitely.
I want at least two hobnobs.
Yeah, all right. But anyway, that way down there, that leads us down to Goring and Streatley. It's about sort of 3 miles as the crow flies. And then at that point, Dave's going to go one way and I'm going to go the other. So, thanks for joining me on this, Dave.
It's all right. No, I've enjoyed it. Usually, I don't know how it is you keep getting the good weather.
Oh, that's lovely, isn't it?
Yeah.
I'm getting the good weather, but what I got to do is get Dave to get an MTB bike. So when we do another journey like this, he can come along then.
Yeah.
His bike, he's on his e-bike. It's not quite up to the rough terrain. So he needs to get an MTB.
You haven't mentioned, I haven't had the power on once. That is all 100%. My own effort.
I can't verify that, but Dave is, I know by nature, a very honest person, so...
You check the battery on that.
He hasn't used his e-bike. He's only, apart from pedalling it.
I'm saving it for the 30 miles going home.
Back home.
Thank you.
down by the Thames almost now. Bit of traffic. Made it to the Thames. The River Thames, a bit goring. This is our Dave's turnaround point. You made it then, Dave.
I've got all the way back now.
You have, yeah. Well done for coming this far anyway.
Yeah.
Well, really appreciate that.
No, it's alright. No, it's nice to see you off. Sure you're on the right road, you know, and heading in the right direction.
Good bit of company. Yeah, and what a nice view, look.
Lovely, isn't it?
Yeah, beautiful.
Are you going in there for lunch?
No, I think I'll give it a miss.
I paid it to Randolph. It's your turn.
Now we're past Goring and Streatley. I'm on the Thames path and just casting around with the camera. Look at the lovely views, absolutely fantastic. Well, the section back there, although it follows the Thames path, it's quite up and down. So I had to get off and push my bike over a few obstacles, tree roots mostly. But look what we've got going on ahead. The Hartley Steps, cyclists proceed with caution. I mean, that is bloody steep. Oh, yeah. I mean, that is steep. This is it. I think I'm going to... I'm going to bottle that, I'm going to walk down that hill, that is so steep. That's steep, steep going down, and I'm pushing going up this one. This feels so wrong, but the GPS says straight on. Looks like we're going into some kind of country estate with gatehouses and all sorts. Look at it, beautiful. I think that was the Hardwick Stud, I'm not sure, but I did see a lorry with Hardwick Stud written on it. So anyway, yeah, onwards and a little bit upwards. I've had to negotiate some traffic, but I'm by the Thames at Reading. Seen so many swans in one place all at one go. They seem to like Reading. Well, that's it, I'm through Reading, I'm out the other side. The little Garmin GPS, it just led me really well, really accurate little device that. Yeah. Hiya.
Hiya.
The chap walking his dog there. Really impressed with the routing of the Garmin Edge Explore 2. Did a fantastic job, no problem whatsoever. I thought I was going to have problems going through Reading, but I didn't. Anyway, it's coming up to 3 o'clock. I'm going to pedal on for about another hour. I'm going to stop, have something to eat, and pedal on for 2 more hours and find camp. Yeah, not bad, a good day. There's a familiar sight for road users for the M4. With the wind turbine in the background there. So I just crossed over the M4, heading back out to the lovely countryside again. It's just gone 4 o'clock, and I'm just coming into a place called Risley. So I've got 2 more hours of good cycling before it starts to sort of get in time to look for somewhere to camp. It's dark, it gets dark about 7:30, so I could go on and for another 3 hours. But I think when I get to 6, I think I'll start looking for somewhere then. No, that's quite impressive. I don't know if it's a big house down there. Yeah. Oh, that I think is a police college. I stopped to admire the area. What a beautiful area. Beautiful views. Just lovely. I would like to camp here, but it's 4:45, so I'm a bit early still. But look at that, isn't that amazing? Unfortunately, disaster has struck my chain. My chain has snapped. Oh, and I'm going to try and find the link. I've got tools, I can get it going again, but I think the quick link has come off somewhere and the chain's just snarled up and fell off. Luckily, when I changed my chain recently, I saved the old link. Slightly worn, but it will get me out of trouble. I'm backpedaling, but I think I'm going to call in at Winchester or somewhere, maybe get a spare chain, because something not right with that, to come off like that. Anyway, we're going again. Well, at least I might, if I don't get a spare chain, I might just get a spare quick link. Okay, I'm near a place called Winchfield. It's 6:15 now. I feel that it's time to find somewhere to camp. I think I'm probably going to try and sneak in over there. I'm going super stealth camping because I think this area is used. There's a little fire over there which is smouldering away. There's nobody there. I think they come and use it as an area to burn rubbish. Maybe on the farm. Neighbouring farm, wherever that is, I've no idea. But I'm down here in the Hoop Bivvy. So I don't think they'll find me down there. Not sure what you can see. It's early. It's almost 6:30, and I just struck camp, packed everything away. It's on the bike. I'm going to wheel it over to the road, but it's still too dark to ride. So got to wait a little bit before I can start pedaling, but I also want to check my chain over because I'm not absolutely sure the quick link that I fitted is good enough. Well, that's the way I'm heading in a minute, but I thought whilst I safely made it to the roadside, I'll get my stove on, make me morning coffee. Well, I'm back on the bike pedaling. The quick link is very loose. It's an old worn quick link, I think, but it'll do hopefully for the time being. I may have to try and find a replacement. But just look at this. What I'm cycling along. I've been following this lovely canal for the last 20 minutes and I've got to leave it now. I think I go under this bridge and then I pick up the road above. Cyclists must dismount, because there's a chance you might fall into the drink. So where I'm at now is a place called Zebon Copse. It's very dark. The battery on this GoPro is not lasting very long, so I'll have to be very, very short with the clips. But I'm heading down that way. Just past the signpost for Farnham, so I'm skirting around Farnham now. Riding down a glorious piece of single track, really nice. I think that's the main, that's Castle Street, so possibly looking down into Farnham there. I've got to go down here a little bit and then turn left. I've got to say, I'd be totally lost without that Garmin Edge Explore sat nav device. It's guided me perfectly so far. Found this petrol station, so I thought I'd stop for some buy some water. And then I saw this. I think it's all right. Well, the Alfreds here in Farnham saved the day. I thought I saw the signpost for Alfreds, popped in there, and for £2.99, two quick links. So if my chain falls off again, I can put it back on, and hopefully it'll stay on. So the link that's on there now isn't very good, but I'll keep pedaling with that one for the time being. I've just come that way, slight uphill. It's very sandy, and I'm heading up that way. Again, more sand in the bottom of the hollow way. But I'm stopping here. I've got myself a pork pie. I've got flapjack bites. And I've got chocolate flavoured milk drink. So I'm going to stop for 10 minutes, get myself refreshed, get some fuel in the tank. Cycling in this amazing heathland. The going's a bit tricky. The going is a bit sort of sandy, you know, and it does affect the rolling resistance handling of the bike. But just look at the vastness, the openness of it. It's all heather. It's just beginning to turn purple in places. Really nice. You couldn't wish for a more scenic ride. I'm sure there probably are more scenic rides to be explored in the future, hopefully. Cycling keeps you fit. Lovely stream. Look at that. Absolutely wonderful. Beautiful. What is not to like? I'll tell you what, how lucky I am to be able to do this just literally 3 weeks away from my 60th birthday. I am blessed, I really am. Been through a major operation and I'm still here. I'm really fortunate. I'm counting my blessings. How about this for a view? I feel like I'm on top of the world, literally. But I'm in sand as well. That's not so good. Let's get over here. Look at the views though. 360. Like this. That's amazing. Now I'm really, really enjoying this. Fantastic ride. I just come that way. And I gotta go that way. There's a ford, but I'm gonna be a coward. I'm not gonna cycle through that. I can just see the bike slipping over, me getting drenched. Nice and cool down here. Yeah, I reckon that's got to be a good 8-10 inches deep. No way am I cycling through there. It's got really tough now, because I'm in sand. Look at it. It's very, very difficult to cycle in sand. In fact, it's nearly impossible. And my route's up there. Oh, I don't know if I'm going to get up there. It's one of those moments where I think I better keep going. The old army boys. The army boys, Funky Prepper, probably camped up behind me. Hi Darren, if you're watching. I'm on the push up to Gibbet Hill. It's really, really hard going, really rough. I mean, you could cycle it if you weren't carrying too much weight. There's a guy up there on the gravel bike, he's pushing. But, this is a tough one, a tough one. That's got to be one of the toughest climbs I've done. I'm on a slight downhill section now, and I think it's a lot more downhill. But again, I've had to stop because of such a wonderful view. This is called the Sailor's Stone. Apparently there was an unknown sailor who was attacked, murdered on this spot by three assailants. So anyway, they put a nice stone there to mark the spot. But I think you'll agree, isn't that a wonderful view? Absolutely lovely. Thank goodness, back on the track now. I had to go for some deep wood at one point with no paths. I think the sat nav was confused. Anyway, we got a signal again. Back on the track. I'll tell you what, there's some proper old Holloway. This has got to be a really ancient track, really ancient. It had to be done. The deer's hut, this is a pub called the Deer's Hut. Cheers. Got a feeling I earned that. Nice packet of crisps as well. I'm now entering the Longmoor Military Training Area. Oh, sand. More sand. I hate sand. Oh, mud! Oh no! More sand! For the last mile and a half, 2 miles, I've been cycling on this lovely abandoned railway track. And I just noticed there's a platform and there's the shelters where people used to wait for the train. So, all those years ago, thanks to Mr. Beeching. This place is a place called Liss, L-I-S-S. Ladies and gents, the sign says it all. Welcome to Est-Sus. Actually, it says West Sussex. I reckon you could cycle that quite easily. Now that was my mistake. I should have come up along here, but I was bombing along so fast, really in the moment, enjoying the speed. I went sailing off down there and missed the track, so I found this little shortcut, but of course there's no way you could cycle that unless you're a nutter. I've been accused of being that in the past. Look at the trees, beautiful. Oh, some climbing. Anyway, just saw this chair. I'm going to sit and stare. That's what I'm going to do. Look at the signpost. The South Downs Way. I'm up on the high chalk downs. I walked the South Downs Way about 3 years ago with Tony and Bill. That was a brutal walk, I tell you. I expect there's some nasty hills to have along here as well. But I'm going to celebrate my arrival at the South Downs Way by a slurp of water. You can tell I'm really pushing the boat out. Two slurps of water. You can't beat Adam's ale. I remember this from my walk of the South Downs Way, all the way up through the fields and up to the ridge up there, and all the way around and down the other side. Oh well, let's get it done. I've been riding bikes for, since I was about 56 years. I suddenly realised why saddles have that little mark there. You see that little mark? It's for this, it's for putting your forearm in like that. And then you lean like that. That's what it's for. Yeah, definitely, it works a treat. Whoever invented that design of the saddle wants a knighthood. It's 10 past 6 and I've made it to Winchester Hill, which is an Iron Age hill fort. Beautiful sunset, beautiful day, very hard day today. The Garmin flipping thing glitched out big time, but I don't know if you can see that. 64.78 miles ridden in 7 hours 57. I climbed 4,206 feet and I descended 5,059 feet. Some of those descents were so flipping hard, you couldn't ride down. They're so bumpy, you had to actually walk the bike down. Anyway, not that you can see it now. The bivvy is set up down there. And that's where I'm going to sleep tonight, on top of Beacon Hill. I camped here before. There's the trig point on Beacon Hill. Terminal, I'm afraid. It is for the bike anyway. Yeah, the frame dropout snapped off. The derailleurs. All I can do is try and convert it into a single speed.